We're back. So.
So were you a Smokey Bear fan?
Well, yeah. Reason I'm chuckling is because, you know, for so long, so many people, me included, called it Smokey the Bear.
The Bear.
The Bear.
Right.
But no, it's Smokey Bear.
Smokey Bear.
Right. That's right.
So. That's right. And I did the same thing. So Kansas has a very unique connection to Smokey Bear. Do you know what that is, Frank?
No, I do not.
The artist that primarily drew Smokey Bear, not the first time, but that drew most of the images that we're familiar with, humanized him, is from Herndon, Kansas, and went to KU.
Wow.
I know. Who knew?
Who knew?
Rudy Wendelin, and he wound up living in Virginia and in the D.C. Suburbs. And just a phenomenal artist. And Smokey Bear, my God, there's hardly a more recognizable figure, icon, advertising personality, whatever the term. You're an advertising guy. What do you call those? What do you call him?
Well, spokesperson.
Okay.
But an animated spokesperson.
But
it would be an icon in this case, yes.
Let's watch this segment about one of Herndon's most famous sons.
And remember, only you can prevent forest fires.
Rudolph Rudy Wendelin was a United States Forest Service employee and the best-known artist behind Smokey Bear, according to the Forest Service's website. Beginning in 1944, Rudy became the full-time artist for the Smokey Bear campaign. He was considered Smokey Bear's caretaker until his retirement in 1973. Rudy was born in Herndon, Kansas on February 27, 1910. He studied architecture at the University of Kansas and studied art at several art schools. He went to work for the U.S. Forest Service in 1933 as an illustrator and draftsman. He served in the United States Navy during World War II and returned to the Forest Service after the war. He completed hundreds of paintings of Smokey Bear. He was not the first to draw the icon, but in his hands, Smokey morphed into the more human image that most Americans recognize. In 1944, Smokey appeared on a poster with the slogan, "Smokey says care will prevent 9 out of 10 forest fires." 3 years later, Smokey's mantra had been amended to the now familiar, "Remember, only you can prevent forest fires." In May 1950, a fire started in the Capitan Gap of New Mexico's Lincoln Forest, destroying 17,000 acres of woodlands. Among the survivors, a 3-month-old black bear cub discovered clinging to a singed pine tree by a crew of firefighters brought in from Texas. A game warden and his family nursed the injured cub. The Forest Service saw in this orphaned bear the opportunity to bring the cartoon to life. The small bear was named Smokey and went to live at the National Zoo in Washington, D.C. His illustrator, Rudy, received the Medal of Honor from the Daughters of the American Revolution in 1998 for his work on the Smokey Bear campaign. Rudy also designed several commemorative postage stamps. Among these were a stamp honoring John Muir, one honoring John Wesley Powell, and a Smokey Bear stamp in 1984. Rudy died from injuries suffered in a car accident in Falls Church, Virginia in 2000, but what an amazing legacy he leaves America.
Hi, I'm Annette from Jackson's. Our annual gigantic sale will be this Saturday, where every plant in the greenhouse and in our nursery, from annual to perennial, shrub, tree, or water plant will be half price. Don't miss our biggest sale of the year.
WIBW Jackson's Greenhouse Garden Club members can shop Friday, Saturday, and Sunday when they present their membership card. They'll receive the 50% sale prices.
Jackson's Greenhouse has what you need today.